Hey Bulldogs, let's see what's happening this week on Code Blue News. Andrew talks about representation in pop culture and Joe updates us on the HMHS theater program. Now please stand for a Pledge of Allegiance in a moment of silence. I pledge of allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Please remain standing for a moment of silence. Thank you.
Hey Bulldogs, I'm Kayron Forbes here with Nick Chaffee. Welcome back to Code Blue Season 4.
Attention all Holbrook students and staff. HMHS is finally allowing spectators for indoor games. With that being said, spectators still must wear a mask at all times and socially distance as much as possible to ensure the safety of yourself and all others.
Have you ever thought to yourself, why does no one in media look like me? Or why does representation in pop culture matter? Well, for many people, especially young students, portrayal of minorities not only affects how others view them, but also how they view themselves. Let's send it over to Andrew Sheehan to learn more on representation in the media and its impact on the masses.
Over the years, numerous TV shows, movies, books, and more have lacked accurate depictions of diversity. Many people would feel more included and seen in our society if pop culture was more inclusive to people that looked and accurately represented themselves.
I think having more representation for, you know, people of color, you know, people of different ethnicities, and, you know, sexualities and all that, I think it would benefit younger generations and pretty much just everybody that it's okay to be yourself because there is someone else who is so out there in the media and unapologetically them.
Diversity is really important in, like, all forms of media because I think it's important for people of different sexualities and gender orientations as well as races and ethnicities should have someone to better relate to.
So there's this show called Raven's Home, and one of the kids, he like wears Jordans and like he wears like kind of more like hip clothing that like you would see kids wearing, and he's also black.
It definitely makes me feel a bit isolated sometimes, I think, because it's like you can look towards your other friends and they have people that they are able to be compared to or like say they're like, but you don't have one. So it sort of kind of makes you feel alone in a sense.
This has been Andrew Sheehan reporting for Code Blue News. Back to you in the studio.
Thank you, Andrew. Speaking of inclusivity for students, October is National Bullying Prevention Month. Let us unite in kindness, acceptance, and tolerance, and remember, Bulldogs don't bully.
Freshmen, class shirt order forms are in Google Classroom. See Ms. Monroe in the guidance office if you need a paper form. Payments are due by the end of the day today. Sophomores, updates on your fundraiser and the link to order class shirts are also in Google Classroom. And as for the juniors, class order forms are now posted on Google Classroom. There will be a quick meeting today after school in Ms. F's room, C132. See Ms. F if you need a printed copy.
Exciting news for the month of November. The HMHS Theater Program will be performing MTIs All Together Now on November 12th. This will be one of the 5,200 performances across the globe.
Wow, that's a lot of singing. Let's go to our very own Joe McLaughlin for more about the event.
For the past 2 years, the school auditorium behind me has been empty and unused for any theatrical performances. However, the wait is over for the return of HMHS Theater.
HMHS Theater has finally made its return to rehearsals in the auditorium for the first time since March of 2020, and its first time making a show since the production of Grease released in April of 2019. HMHS, along with hundreds of other theaters all over the world, will be putting together the production of All Together Now, a unique compilation of songs from various musicals encouraging the return to theater across the globe.
All Together Now is a production that has been given to us free of charge from Music Theater International. And the hope is that globally, around the world, people will be doing this show on November 12th. Hopefully, we'll jumpstart an interest in musical theater. It's been 2 years since we've been able to do a show, so we need to kind of start from the ground up and get back to doing what Holbrook Middle High School does best and put on a great show.
This huge call back to the theater across the globe was quickly and passionately answered, as the existence of a show meant a lot to both directors and actors alike.
It means a lot to me because I know how much it means a lot to the students that we work with. We literally haven't had a production in almost 2 years, and that's a lot, especially for students that have been doing it year after year, veteran performers, new performers that have maybe started with us in theater camp. It means the most to me because it means a lot to our students.
Being back, it feels really great, actually. I missed having rehearsals and being here, so now that I'm able to perform again, it feels good.
Rehearsals for the show are currently every Monday and Tuesday night from 6 to 8. If you are interested, please email Mrs. Claher or Ms. Morgan. The production of All Together Now will be at the HMHS Auditorium on the night of November 12th. This is Joseph McLaughlin reporting for CoBlue News.
Thanks, Joe. For any seniors who are applying to college, the FAFSA form launches today, October 1st. For more information, please visit FAFSA.gov. If you have any questions, contact Ms. Moriarty.
Before we wrap up, let's see how the Holbrook teams did this week in sports.
Hey, Bulldogs. I'm Sam Hobart, and welcome back to This Week of Sports. Last weekend, the girls' varsity volleyball team, led by Olivia Hingston and Lauren Gideon, beat Nantucket High School 3-0. The following week, the volleyball team beat South Shore Christian Academy on Tuesday 3-0, but faced a tough loss to Bishop Conley on Wednesday and lost 3-0. Their last game of the week was played yesterday against Westport, and their record now stands at 8 wins and 2 losses. On Saturday, the football team took a trip down to Cape Cod Tech and won their game 6-0. Brady Sheehan rushed 65 yards, and Davion Scott wrapped up the play and scored a 3-yard touchdown for the Bulldogs. This season has been the most consistent winning streak the Holbrook's football team has had since 2012. After winning 2 games back-to-back, the Bulldogs are making their way to Fall River today versus Atlantis Charter School at 6. The cross-country team had a meet against Southeastern on Thursday. On Wednesday, the girls' varsity soccer team, led by Sarah Sullivan and Taylor Dolan, had an away game against Westport, where they won 1-0. Their last game this week was yesterday at home against South Shore Christian Academy. Finally, the boys' soccer team, led by Giovanni Cohen and Owen Cahill, had a home game yesterday against South Shore Christian Academy as well. That's all for sports. This has been Sam Hobart reporting for CoBlue News. Back to you in the studio.
Thanks, Sam. Thursday's girls' varsity soccer beat South Shore Christian Academy 8-0, with the boys also taking the win against them 5-1. The cross-country team traveled to South Shore Southeastern, and the girls won 41-20 as the boys won 47-16. Volleyball took a tough loss to Westport 3-0. As for today, varsity football travels to Atlantis Charter, while boys' varsity soccer heads to Cardinal Spelman. Good luck to all the teams.
And now we will begin by mentioning all of the student government results, and our apologies if we butcher any names. There are a lot. Let's begin. So for all the student council officers, the president is Marissa Todd, the vice president is Dallas Rodriguez Vieira, the secretary is Bridget Moore, the treasurer is Emma Pepe, and for community relations is Hannah Altador.
For class of 2022, president Dallas Rodriguez, vice president Bridget Moore, secretary Marissa Todd, treasurer Tiana DeCanto, student council representative Aaron Colty, Joseph McLaughlin, Hovind No, and Vin Nguyen.
For the class of 2023, the president is Emma Pepe, the vice president is Kylie Eschner, the secretary is Kaylee Mangola, the treasurer is Hannah Altador, and the student council representatives are Emily Donahue, Heather Hilton, Justin Jerome, and Riley Pentagast.
Class of 2024, president Serena Terbisi, vice president Alicia Killian, secretary Derek Fox, treasurer Calvin Mungai, student council representative Derek Fox, Alicia Killian, and Kevin Mungai.
For the class of 2025, the president is Gianna Mangola, the vice president is Jada Gideon, the secretary is Tevin No, the treasurer is Abigail DeMarco, and the student council representative is Theana Raymond.
Class of 2026, student council representative Ala Baptista, Dylan Fox, Laurie Fracchilli, Katie Nguyen, and Ayanna White.
For the class of 2027, the student council representatives are Jaylene Etienne, Juliana Ford, Haley Hoyt, Natalie Morales, and Sama Ziad.
Class of 2028, student council representative Caitlin Curry, Richard Ferry, Rodney Montard, Robert Sturfold, and Isabella Vallard.
And for the student advisory board, the members are Hannah Altidore, Kaylee Mangola, Emma Pepe, Dallas Rodriguez-Villa, and Marissa Todd.
And for the school council is Kaylee Mangola and Hovind Now.
The newly elected freshman class officer should stop in Ms. Gallagher's room after school today. Newly elected middle school representatives will have a meeting Tuesday after school from 2:15 to 2:45 in Ms. Gallagher's room, C131. There will be a high school student council meeting in Ms. Gallagher's room Wednesday from after school from 2:15 to 2:45. Newly elected freshman class officers should stop in Ms. Gallagher's room after school today. Newly elected middle school representatives will have a meeting Tuesday after school from 2:15 to 2:45 in Ms. Gallagher's room. There will be a high school student council meeting in Ms. Gallagher's room Wednesday after school from 2:15 to 2:45. Congratulations to all those that were elected.
That wraps up this week. I'm Kayron Forbes.
And I'm Nick Chaffee. See you next Friday.